Hello everyone, welcome to this video in the time, speed and distance series. In this video, we're going to talk about problems related to the boats and streams. This video is brought to you by Learning Made Easy team, a team of IIM grads in association with our e-learning partner GTCUBE, Get to the Top. If you're watching this video in the YouTube channel, do check out our full-length course available for free at gtcube.com/store, where you'll get to watch these videos as part of the course and also get to practice hundreds of questions on these concepts that would help you to understand them much better. So let's get started. So the boats and streams are slight extension to the very basic time, speed and distance. The very important piece of information that you'll get to read in the question that would help you, you know, to guess that, okay, this question is based on the boats and streams topic, is basically talking about upstream, downstream, are the boat going against the current or along the current. So there will be two things that you need to know. The speed of boat or whatever the entity that's moving in water, in still water, is one speed that you have to know as a value or take as a variable. The other thing would be speed of the water itself, or the river, the stream, or the current, whatever. So it's like basically this. Water is not moving, and there's a boat which is moving at some speed. After an hour, the boat would cover that distance B, because the speed is B kilometers per hour, whatever I assume. If there is a flow in water also, right? Let's assume the water is flowing in this direction, there will be speed for the water. Let's assume the water is flowing at a speed r kilometers per hour. If there is a boat here, if the boat is also moving at a speed of b kilometers per hour, after an hour, it would actually cover b plus r, because the boat is helped by the river flow. It is because the river is flowing in this direction, it will push the boat. Even if there's a boat is idle, right? Let's assume the boat is not having any speed. The river is flowing at a speed of r. After an hour, the boat should have covered the r kilometers, because the river is pushing the boat, right? So there will be three situations. One, there is no flow in the water. So there's a boat, after an hour, it will still go at speed of b kilometers per hour. There will be flow in the river or the stream or current, which is going in one direction, and the boat is also going in the same direction. Then the boat is helped by the river flow. So the boat would have covered P plus R, or the net speed of the boat is actually now boat speed plus the river speed. In this case, it's just the net speed is boat speed alone. And there could be a situation where the water is flowing in one direction and the boat is going in an opposite direction. In that case, the boat is actually helped in the negative manner. That is, the boat is pushed against or in the negative way. So boat would actually cover a distance of b minus r, because boat alone would have covered b kilometers in an hour, but water would push it r kilometers behind, so it would cover b minus r. So the net speed would be b minus r. You know, this scenario where the water flow and the boat direction is same is generally known as downstream or along the current. This, when the boat is going in opposite direction as the river flow, that's called as upstream situation or against the current. Right? All you need to use is just the speed into time is distance for these problems as well. It's just about using the right net speed depending on what situation we are in. And also have to understand there are two different speeds which are used together to find the net speed. So there will be two possible scenarios. Upstream and against the current, as I said, there will be speed of boat and there will be speed of river. This is speed of boat in still water, that's how they'll call it. That is, when there is no flow in the river, what is the speed of the boat? So in the upstream situation, the net speed would be upstream, speed of boat minus speed of river, because the river will be pushing against in the negative manner. And then the distance upstream and the time taken upstream, right? The formula would be same. Distance upstream is equals to time taken in upstream flow into the net speed in the upstream, that's SB minus SR. We just get couple of things out of this and calculate whatever is not given. When it comes to the downstream, again the same thing, SB and SR. It's just that the net speed in the downstream situation or along the current would be, I need to add both because this river is flowing in the same direction as the boat direction. So it is helping it, so I need to add. So again the same as D downstream, time downstream. So the connection would be D downstream, the distance covered will be the time downstream into the net speed downstream, that's SB plus SR. We just need to use this formulas to calculate the given information in the question. So let's dive into the problems. So you can pause the video and try these problems on your own. After you've solved them or given a good shot, follow this video to understand how to solve them. So there's a boat rows at 20 kilometers against the current, right? That's basically like the upstream situation, taking 5 hours time. So time taken is 5 hours. The distance is 20 kilometers. And the speed of the current or the river is 5 kilometers per hour. I don't know the speed of the boat. That is what the question is also asking in the still water. Because the situation is upstream, the net speed would be speed of boat minus speed of river. So SB minus 5. So net speed is equals to distance by time. So 20 kilometers in 5 hours, so that would come out to be 4 kilometers per hour. What is the net speed? SB minus 5. So that will give me SB as 9 kilometers per hour. That's the speed of boat in the still water. Now that's how you'll solve these questions. Arun can row a certain distance downstream in 4 hours, right? When he goes downstream. So I don't know the speed of boat yet, speed of river yet. Let's see if that's given. The downstream time is given as 4 hours. The distance, no idea. Whereas upstream, what time does he take? He takes 12 hours. The distance would be same because they said return the same distance in 12 hours. So if he's going downstream, the returning should be upstream. That's against the flow. If the stream flows at a rate of 5 kilometers per hour, this given to be 5 kilometers per hour, find the speed of Arun's boat in still water. This is what they're asking me. So what is the distance? Distance is equal to speed into time, right? So the speed downstream, the net speed is SB plus SR, that is SB plus 5. So this distance would be SB plus 5 into 4. Similarly, upstream, the net speed upstream would be SB minus SR. So distance would be speed into time, SB minus 5 into 12 hours. So the distance covered is both in the both upstream and downstream is same. I can equate both the values. So SB plus 5 into 4 is 4SB plus 4 5s are 20. Should be equal to 12SB minus 12 5s are 60. So 60 goes here and 4SB. So 60 plus 20, 80 is equals to 12 minus 4, 8SB. So speed of boat in still water would be 10 kilometers per hour. Now that's how you'll solve these questions. There will be some clue, same distance, or sometimes we'll talk about the time taken for different distances. You just need to connect the proper clue just by using the net speed into time is distance in the proper way and solve the question. So you see this question, there's a man who can row 9 kilometers per hour in still water. To row upstream, it takes him thrice as long as to row down the river. So the upstream time is basically 3 times the downstream. They said the speed of man in the still water is 9 kilometers per hour. I don't know the speed of river. I just need to find that. So the distance is same in both the scenarios, upstream and downstream. So what is the time upstream? The connection would be distance traveled by the net speed upstream. Similarly for downstream also the same. What is the net speed upstream? speed of boat plus, sorry, minus speed of river. So that is 9 minus SR. The net speed downstream would be speed of boat plus speed of river. That will be 9 plus SR. So time up is distance by net speed upstream is 9 minus SR is equals to 3 into time downstream would be distance traveled by 9 plus SR. That is, time is distance by speed for upstream and downstream. So DD will get cancelled out. I just need to cross multiply. 9 plus SR is equals to 27 minus 3 SR. 3 SR plus, it goes this side, 9 comes this side. 27 minus 9 would be 18. This will be 4 SR. And SR is 18 by 4. That will be 4.5 kilometers per hour. Right, whatever the way the clues are set, all you need to do is, okay, find is this which of these two is given, calculate the net speed upstream, downstream, use the formulas, time into speed is distance. If you remember this case, they gave the clue as the distance as being same. In this case, the clue is that the time taken upstream is 3 times the time taken downstream, so I can just solve using that clue. Whatever the format of the clue is, you just have to finally apply this formula, speed into time is distance. And this speed is basically the net speed. Should I subtract, should I add? Just do that and just solve them like we do the basic time, speed and distance questions. So thank you for watching this video. If you're watching this video in the YouTube channel, do check out our full length course available for free at gtcube.com/store. You will get to watch these videos as part of course and also get to practice hundreds of questions on this concept. Also do like our partner's Facebook page, facebook.com/gtcube3. We're coming up with a lot of content and courses that would help you in your preparation. You'll get all those updates over there. Finally, thank you for watching this video and let's meet in the next video.